The WISPR instrument, which stands for a wide field imager for solar probe, is an instrument that is an investigation that's on the Parker Solar Probe. The mission, the solar probe, the concept of going close to the sun, which is what this mission is, was actually proposed in 1958 by the Space Studies Board right at the formation of NASA.
The Parker Solar Probe is a revolutionary mission that has been 60 years in the making, and it is going to go deep into the heart of the sun's corona, that hazy atmosphere that we see during a total solar eclipse. And it's going to be zipping through there at breathtaking speeds, getting data that scientists have really been waiting for more than 60 years, to finally answer some of the mysteries of our corona and allow us to be able to explain really how our star works. We live in the atmosphere of the sun. So when something happens on the sun, we will actually feel the effects here at Earth. So if the sun sneezes, the Earth will catch a cold. Anything that happens on there is going to be felt here at the planet. And so us being able to explain what is going on in this critical region that we've never been able to sample before means that Parker Solar Probe will finally be able to answer these questions for us. So the Parker Solar Probe really carries all the instruments that we need to make these critical measurements. And we do have a full suite of instruments that are measuring particles. They're going to tell us what's coming in the solar wind. They're going to measure all the fields, the magnetic, the electric fields. But we also have a very novel instrument that is a white light imager, and that is designed and built by the Naval Research Lab, who of course has a long history in providing optical instruments for NASA. And we're going to rely very much on this imager that is going to fly on the Parker Solar Probe.
The WISPR, it is a telescope, or several telescopes, that block the disk of the sun, that block the diffracted light, actually. We're using the heat shield as the first stage in blocking the sun, but then light gets scattered off the edge of that, and we block those that diffracts that scattered light.
It's an unusual imager in that it's not going to take pictures of the sun like we are used to seeing. It's actually going to take images of the solar wind right in front of the spacecraft. And so having these images that tell us, well, this is what we're about to fly through, are going to make so much difference to our ability to unlock the secrets in our data. And so it's such an important instrument for really helping us to understand what these measurements in this region we've never been to. We don't know quite what we're going to expect, but it's going to be taking the images that we need to better help us understand those data.
The problem for space weather and the Navy is that what this mission is going to be able to do is to pin down exactly what the structure close to the sun is, the overall structure. We'll be able to image that. But also, there's an experiment that will measure the strength of the magnetic field, electric fields, and that sort of thing. The structure of the plasma that we're running through. And those are key parameters in helping us to better predict, better model the propagation of the solar wind through this huge region, 100 million miles between the sun and Earth.
So one of the results that could possibly come from Parker Solar Probe that I'm most excited about is nothing at all. And I mean that literally. It's from a conversation with Dr. Ross Howard early on in the mission. He explained to me that very close to the sun, there is a lot of dust. It's a very dusty place, a lot of stardust that we will be flying through. But people have theorized that very close to the sun, there's actually a dust-free region. But of course, we can't see it from here because we're always looking through the dust. But with the orbit of Parker Solar Probe and having this WISPR imager from NRL, we'll be able to image close enough to the sun to hopefully see nothing at all, and finally prove that this dust-free region is really there.
What we're going to achieve is just absolutely amazing. It's just, all I can say is stay tuned, because we're going to see stuff that we just have never imagined, I'm sure.